goes numb, you take a coffee break, you turn back to us.
What up? Ready for a rad tat? How about a teardrop by the eye? Make you look hard. I've done all these 100 times. I'm good at it. Took that well. Yeah, something unique out of a catalog. Yep, looks good. Some award-winning art in there. That's a masterpiece. I'm good. I'm using this money for drugs. Be good.
Thank you. Don't be a dick, bro. I'm trying to look out for you. Just give me the keys.
Whatever, Dad. Totally fine. Just had a couple of beers.
What are you talking about? We had like 6 shots each. Look at you.
Will you two just make out already?
Hey, can you give me a ride just so Boy Scout there can get his buzzkill badge? There's my car.
Where we go?
I'm on Alta Place. Howick Ave? It's not that far.
Oh, I don't feel so good. I just got a mouthful of something.
You better take it slow. Hey, thanks for this, man. As you can see, I could have
lucky miss.
No problem, but you don't make me hurl. No problem, but Joy Killer back there had to lay a guilt trip on me.
You believe he wanted me to walk?
Walk? I don't recognize any of this. I hope you know where you're going.
You believe he wanted me to walk?
Walk? Do you think this is Europe?
It's because I sound drunk.
What the fuck, dude?
It's because I sound drunk doesn't mean my brain's drunk.
You know, it's offensive. You don't call a deaf kid stupid for talking funny.
I can't believe he just walked out without me. Why did guys turn into such assholes? Look out!
Oh, shit. I'm gonna... Barf!
Oh, that's it, little man! Sing me a rainbow!
Dude, sorry about that. Most of it went out the window. I'll throw some cash your way.
Now, try that again without slurring.
Well, yeah, I feel much better. That tactical vomit really sorted me out.
Starving now. Oh, yes! I still got some clucking bell at home from last night. I am all over that!
I tell you, the planets are aligned, bro. Karma is sucking my boy right now.
You can always try shutting up. See how that feels.
Are you crazy?
Oh, shit.
a deadly weapon in, web. Chile is an outstate wilderness.
Points!
Nope.
Look at me! What'd you expect? Miss me!
There you are, Trevor.
If it ain't my favorite marksman, huh? How are you, Cletus?
Fine and dandy, sir. You ready to hunt some elk?
Beat satellite dishes. Lead the way.
Oh, here you go. Now, put this in your mouth. A bad day hunting still beats a good day working, my pa always used to say.
What is this thing in my mouth? And why do I have the feeling I'm not the first person to use it?
I'll explain that in a while. Let's start with the basics for now. Elk senses are razor sharp. If they see you or hear you, you'll spook them, and they'll bolt. You gotta move slowly and quietly and keep that aside. But an elk's nose is as big as defense. When you're tracking elk, you always need to watch the wind direction. If you don't stay downwind of them, they'll pick up your scent and be gone before you can say boo, especially with that distinctive, musk of yours.
I'm calling pot and kettle on that, my friend.
Don't aim at something you ain't prepared to kill. All right, this is a prime area right here. You feeling ready, Trevor?
Raring to go.
Okay, let's see if we can bag ourselves some elk. I saw a young bull using a down tree to scratch his antlers on not 10 minutes ago. Follow me. I'll keep us downwind so we don't spook him. Go on, put him down. Much cleaner than that. Hey, I thought you was having fun. Don't be lagging back there. All right, stick with me. I'll lead us further in. Keep quiet and stay close. I ain't seen much else or nothing else out here. But we're gonna have to see if we can coax one into the open. That's where that thing you've been chewing on comes in.
Ah, yes. Please enlighten me. It tastes like old person.
That's a diaphragm. Mm-hmm. An elk whistle to you and me. All right, give it a good blow. See if we can get any nearby elk to holler back.
Sounds like someone strangling a clarinet player, and I talk from experience.
Shh, listen. Okay, you hear that? He's over there. You're downwind, so he's yours to lose, Trevor. Go get him! You blew his damn head off. Okay, follow me. We'll move a little further in. Stay quiet. I think we might have a mating pair up ahead. Let's check it out. Now, remember, if it's a pair, we're only here for the male. No does. That's my rule. So if you see one with no antlers, leave it be. Blow your whistle again. See if you can get a beat on him. Hey, this is good. Same as before. Okay, follow me. We'll move a little further in. Stay quiet. I think we might have a mating pair up ahead. Let's check it out. Now, remember, if it's a pair, we're only here for the male. No does. That's my rule. So if you see one with no antlers, leave it be. Blow your whistle again. See if you can get a beat on them. Okay, this is good. Same as before. Nice and steady. Now lay him in the shade. You got this now, Trevor. You're on your own for the next one. Tell you what, I got an idea how we can go in on this together. Text me a pic of your next kill, and we'll talk business. I gotta go. Good luck. I'll holler at you in a while. Got the photo. Another nice kill. So this is what I'm thinking. All this demand for wild-raised meat with them city folks right now? If we divide and conquer, I reckon we could make ourselves a tidy little sideline. Text me a photo of your quarry. I'll let you know what it's worth and come by to pick it up as soon as I can. I like my meat with some age on it anyways. What do you say?
Yeah, I say we'll see. I got a few other irons in the fire at the moment.
All right, well, the offer's there. And you can keep that elk collar. Was my grandma's before she passed. Be hearing from you.
dumbass!
They set me up!
Don't do it!
Believe it.
Of course.
What? Utterly ridiculous.
Hey, dude, just buy something and leave, okay? You can't go wrong with any of this stuff.
I'm a trucker, and sometimes I doze off or swerve off the road a bit while, you know, masturbating and thinking about ballet recitals and jetpacks and such.
cars. Look, technology is going to make us all obsolete. Example, a coal miner doesn't want to make solar panels. How is he going to look his boy in the face and say, I'll make them there big, tough solar panels, boy. Let's go have some quinoa and almond milk.
All my windows at home covered by 2x4s.
To shoot him, okay? It is my mission with this show to make everyone understand the real things you should be worrying about. This globalist agenda, the estrogen teeming through all of our veins. Oh, God. Pretty soon, we'll all be the same color and we'll speak one language. Like in that documentary with the robots. Globalists want to just open our borders and have some, like, kind of big-ass party.
Those are pretty popular.
With that loud ethnic music while the rest of us just cower in our bunkers.
Leave it
on its way.
Son of a bitch!
I need a cat.
Nope.
Okay, buddy, there you go.
Wonderful.
A veritable treasure trove. Just ignore us.
Yes, don't mind us. Pretend we're not here.
Okay.
You're not Jock Cranley, are you? Actor and artist? I love your work. Oh, Stunt Double? Oh, our favorite show. Mrs. Thornhill, snap!
Watch the birdie!
Oh, pretend to throttle me. Yes, like you did on that poster you did.
Yeah, okay, well, that would be my pleasure.
Oh.
Like that, huh?
Yeah. Oh.
Maybe something like this? Or like that? Huh? You like that?
That's enough, huh? Andrew!
You like that?
Stop!
Ooh.
Please!
Oh, hey! Oh.
Thank you.
Wow, that's quite a woman there, huh? Oh.
We are not worthy. We're not worthy.
We're not worthy.
I'm not Jock, what's his name?
Cranley. Big star in the 80s.
We love celebs. That's why we came to Tinseltown.
Yes. Before we met you, we were trying to break in to Bruce Spade's house and steal his rubbish.
The things these stars throw away. They're not like you or me.
Mrs. Thornhill has the most unbelievable collection of celebrity underwear and bathroom products. Things they've actually used themselves.
You guys have a great vacation, all right? I gotta go.
We could do with some help. All this climbing over walls and rooting through bins, it's such a business. Nigel's got an arthritic knee. Yeah.
What do you need?
Just a few vinewood souvenirs for my museum.
Look at this map. I mean, a lot of these places have famous people living in them, and some that are just hanging about. Bring us some things. I'd be very thankful indeed.
Americans are the most wonderful people in the world, aren't they?
The best!
Such fun!
Ah, pair of fruitcakes.
Could you? I mean, this is low even for you, Pinhead.
Man!
Jackass! You're getting robbed!
Shit! Cops!
Copy that! We're in the area!
There you are, you little shit. Are you looking for this?
No.
Very funny. You know, you're a real asshole.
What did you just fucking say to me?
Stop it! You're ruining my fucking yoga!
Somebody say yoga?
Trevor?
Michael.
Hey. It's good to see you, man.
Yeah, I bet it is. Of course, I'm not the one that's been resurrected. Ain't this grand, huh?
Yeah, well, I got in a bit of an awkward situation.
You're telling me, bro. Yeah. One of those fake your own deaths to your best buddy, and then run off with the dough, and then live in a big mansion. Awkward situations.
It's one way of looking at it.
Yeah, do you have any other ways of looking at it? Because I am all out.
Look, it was a long time ago, man. I've been in witness protection. I still am. That's great. That's great.
I'm sorry. Where are my manners, right? Amanda, it is good to see you. Oh, I missed you. You used to be fatter. Nice new tits, by the way. Jimmy, you used to be thinner, but can't blame you. Who are you?
Namaste. I'm Fabian.
Good Lord. Where's Tracy?
Where's your sister, Jim?
She's trying out for TV.
She's what?
Yeah, she's auditioning for Fame or Shame.
Fame or Shame?
The fuck are you talking about?
You know, it's that talent / skills show. She loves it, you guys know that.
What's her talent?
Dancing.
Oh, Christ, she's a horrible dancer.
Michael!
She might disagree with you on that.
Jesus Christ, what, now? Now? Where?
The Maze Bank Arena.
Oh, little Tracy being humiliated. Let's go, we go get her.
We?
Yeah, we. What, are you gonna stand here and argue while your daughter becomes a national laughingstock? Huh? You're worse than I thought. Now let's go, come on!
All right.
So, Mike, what were you doing?
I was making myself a juice. Broccoli, raw kale, fish oil. This recipe I got is packed with nutrients, fibers, vitamins, and it don't taste bad. I'll send you the recipe. Anyway, get this. I'm making it. The blender slips. Juice goes everywhere. I'm about to clean it up when I find this bag of grass. Big fucking bag. Jimmy's, right? Okay, just that moment, Amanda comes in. Sees me there with.
I didn't ask for a blow-by-blow of how you lost your last ounce of masculine pride. I wanted to know what you've been doing for a decade.
Easy, T.
Don't tea me.
Hey, if anyone needs kale, my friend.
I'm beyond pale, okay?
It's too late for kale. And its magical powers to have any effect on me.
Fine.
Or yoga. Or talk therapy. I'm a crank, cannibalism, an incest kind of guy.
Oh, don't worry, T. They'd skip that talk and go straight to shock treatment with your ass.
You too chilled out to say my name, you fat slob. You too relaxed, and you laid back Los Santos embarrassment, huh? Is one letter all you can bring yourself to wrap your slothful lips around?
Whoa, dude, you do not let the fuck up.
I've got 10 years worth of venting to do. The let up, my friend, is a long way off.
Fine, fine. Do what the fuck you want.
Want? Well, I want to save your daughter from making an ass of herself.
Oh, really, man? Really? What is it? Money or a fight? What? What do you come here looking for?
I came looking for you.
Let's make this.
And I found you.
Yes, okay. You did.
I know who you are, Michael Townley. You're in a new place with some new friends and some fruity fucking habits, but you're still my running buddy. You can't undo that.
Yeah, sure, okay, whatever.
Great!
Hey, you wanna see this audition or not? Wait a minute, I'm confused. Are you driving through the stadium? Trevor, the stadium, we going? At this rate, we're gonna miss my little girl's big moment. Hey, you want to see this audition or not? Wait a minute, I'm confused. Are you driving through the stadium? Trevor, the stadium, we going? At this rate, we're gonna miss my little girl's big moment. Hey, you want to see this audition or not? Wait a minute, I'm confused. Are you driving through the stadium? Trevor, the stadium, we going? At this rate, we're gonna miss my little girl's big moment. Don't crash this car again. Hey, you want to see this audition or not? Hey, hey!
Okay, this'll be it. Maze Bank Arena. Let's find them.
It's showtime, kids!
These phases are reserved for production vehicles.
Oh, fuck. I'm gonna kill you,
dick!
Come on, you dipshit.
Ah, that host, man. He's like any closeted TV presenter. Bitter as fucking vinegar.
Where the fuck are they?
Hello, sir. May I please have your names?
Where the fuck is Tracy Townley, huh? Tracy fucking DeSanta, fuck, screw that! Where the fuck's Laszlo?
It doesn't matter.
Please be quiet.
You're gonna be just as good then as I've been.
All right. Yeah. That was really
good.
All right. It's the auditions, Fame or Shame, season 14, right here in Vinewood, San Andreas. Coming up next, it's Tracy DeSanta. Judges, Tracy DeSanta. Yes.
Hi.
All right. Tracy's a dancer, but she also likes acting, modeling, and working with children. That's beautiful. You're so original, like a basket full of puppies or a rainbow or a pile of puke.
Oh.
Who are these clowns?
That's my dad and... Trevor?
Two dads. Great.
Wow.
Barry San Andreas.
What are you guys doing here?
Yeah, what are you doing here?
Okay, I'm back.
Relax. Three, two, one. All right, it's Fame or Shame for Tracy DeSanta. Music!
When I came home last night, you wouldn't make love to me. You went fast asleep.
Yeah.
You wouldn't even talk to me.
Take what your daddy's gave you, honey.
I'm so crazy.
Ooh, your dad's stuff a 20 in this.
Oh!
Fucking do something about this.
That's enough.
Oh, I said that's enough! Hey, I got security! Security! Security!
What'd you fucking
say? Come on, big guy! Come up there!
No!
Fuck!
No!
Come here, you little shit!
No!
Tracy! Go home! Come back here!
They towed us! We gotta take the truck!
There! We take the truck!
Hey!
Hey! Not my rig!
We're running that prick down!
We gotta go to the left!
How can you sit there and watch your daughter get treated like that?
Hey, you raised a daughter in this town to get used to stunts.
It's poor parenting.
Now, thanks for the fucking feedback. It means a lot coming from you.
No one's getting in the way of the big rig!
We'll flatten this dick bag. Fucking Laszlo. I knew he was an asshole.
Just push him off the fucking road! It's only a battery car, come on!
This ain't exactly a racer.
He took a left! Ah, the little bastard's going onto the train tracks! We can have a little fun with him, but let's not try to kill this prick, all right?
When we crush his little toy car, who knows what'll happen to him?
Look, he went left!
City would be full of douchebags.
Can we speed it up a little, huh?
Maybe by throwing your fat carcass over the side.
He took a right. Can you? 10 fucking minutes in LS.
Shut up! That cocksucker might be famous, but we'll get him! We'll get him!
But we're sure taking our time about it. He's going down into the LS River.
I can see that. I hate that closeted man whore on the TV. I hate him on the radio. I hate him even more in person. He was never funny. The little shit's all out of juice.
Hey, you guys.
You run out of batteries, huh?
I didn't mean anything by it, all right?
Oh, yeah? Well, that little girl sat on my lap when she was 2 years old, and I swore to God that I would rip the fucking skin off anyone who fucking wronged her.
Look, I'm just a dumb A-list celebrity trying to entertain America, okay? I got a lot of stuff going on right now, dude, besides you trying to kill me. Now I got multiple sexual harassment lawsuits, plus I'm an addict, all right? And I've relapsed. I can't stop jacking, dude. I jack it in traffic.
What's your talent, huh? I mean, aside from love and sex.
Dude, haven't you seen my show? It's not live, it's not funny. That's my genius. I got no fucking talent.
You clearly ain't being humble, T. You proved your point.
This is your daughter. You should be wanting to rip the fucking ponytail off the back of this guy's head. And you! Pants off.
Okay.
There you go. All right.
What are you doing?
Now, I want you to dance sexy, celebrity.
I mean, I need music or...
Are you trying to fucking annoy me, huh?
I'll dance.
Good. What the fuck is that? All right. Now drop it like it's hot, all right? I want to see you get nice and low. Come on. Lower. Lower. Come on.
Please don't kill me, okay? I'm supposed to be on a magazine cover next week.
All right. Come on. Get up. Take off. Go. Now. Before I change my mind.
I got it all on my camera, you fucking pussy. The world's gonna see your shit!
I'm going home.
How the fuck did you do it without me for 9 years, huh?
Oh, shit.
Dave.
We need to talk.
I was about to tell you the same thing.
Okay. Meet me at Galileo Observatory as soon as you can get there.
Okay. Hey there, she-hipster.
Yo.
Yeah, hey, I need a kid.
Of course.
Okay, thanks for your help. All cool? Hey, you! Really?
Whatever.
It's on. You should get some help with that personality.
Keep coolio, baby! It's just a car.
Oh, really? Estamos en Islos FM, y esto es...
Hi, Mama.
I was gonna call you.
It's hard to get time off at the moment.
Davey, how you doing?
About as good as can be expected, but the news is not good.
I don't know what you're talking about.
I know you did that fucking jewelry job.
Davey, seriously, you're imagining things.
Fuck you.
All right. I did it. Arrest me. You know what? You'll be saving my life. Because you called it, motherfucker.
What?
You called it.
Trevor.
Couple days ago. But we haven't really talked about anything either.
But if, no, when he starts asking questions about why you're not feeding worms south of the Canadian border. Oh, we got problems.
Yeah, no shit.
We're in it.
Together.
So, if your problems are my problems, then I guess that means that my problems are sort of your problems.
Nope.
What if I lose my job? Someone comes into my office, starts reading my files. They'll see the things I did. I know a lot of stuff. I can cop a plea, get 5 years, but you...
Fuck you, you ungrateful prick. I made your career.
Well... and we better go about saving it together, because you and I both know we can't let it go to shit now.
What do you need?
This guy, Ferdinand Karamov. The agency claims he's dead. We at the Bureau think they're full of crap. We think he's being debriefed someplace.
So?
Apparently. He has information which will put me and my superiors out of circulation. Those agency fuckers have got the coroner's office locked down. We need you to verify the body.
So how the hell am I gonna get in here?
Well, you've played dead before, haven't you? I have always kinda liked you.
Call me when you wake up. I'll tell you what.
What we got?
John Doe, white male, overweight, in his late 40s, possible coroner.
Let's take a peek.
The fat deposits on his hips and abdomen suggest a fondness for bleeder burgers.
We're probably about to find one in his gut, still in its wrapper.
Right next to the bottle of scotch and pack of Redwoods. See the broken capillaries around the nose?
Alcoholic.
I wouldn't take any bets on the state of the liver.
We still think 40s?
Takes a toll.
He's an advert for clean living.
Note the discoloration of the teeth and the fingers.
Smoker.
Pack a day, I'd say. Probably cigars, too.
I was going like there was no tomorrow. What the hell was that?
Don't worry, it's just gas.
No, no. It's reanimating.
You want to cut it in the coroner's office, you're going to have to lose the nerves.
I've been around cadavers. This isn't right.
Well, fresh is different. The ones you've seen have been on the shelf for a week. You can still smell this guy's breakfast.
You say so.
The things I've seen in this place. Grown man you could fit into a sandwich bag. Bodies that are more maggots than flesh. This gas bag here is a blessing. He's got that right. Some people think they're immortal.
So you get chest pains pumping away at your mistress.
Lucky girl having this thing on top of her, huh?
She was probably relieved when he bought it.
Awkward conversation with the spouse. Might have got some hush money.
It's a win-win.
Only losers are the chumps who've got to cut him open to rule cause of death. Get ready with the bone saw and the rib spreader. You might want to hold your nose.
What we got?
John Doe. White male, overweight, in his late 40s, possible coroner.
Let's take a peek.
The fat deposits on his hips and abdomen suggest a fondness for bleeder burgers.
We're probably about to find one in his gut, still in its wrapper.
Right next to the bottle of scotch and pack of Redwoods. See the broken capillaries around the nose?
Alcoholic.
I wouldn't take any bets on the state of the liver.
We still think 40s?
Takes a toll.
He's an advert for clean living.
Note the discoloration of the teeth and the fingers.
Ah! Oh, Jesus!
Got back from the dead, motherfucker!
Come out! Hands in the air! Come on. Might be in the other room. Surrender yourself! Give it up!
That don't look right. Guess you can't judge a corpse by its toe tag. I found the toe tag. Ferdinand Karamov. It's on some big black lady. Definitely not your guy.
Okay. The agency have the lower floors on lockdown to prevent a leak. I got a guy who can cut the power to give you some help. But you'll have to get upstairs if you're gonna get out.
Hey, stop! Everyone back! I've got your number!
Just let me go!
It's a national security issue. Chain the trap.
That's what we have in mind.
I don't know what's going on here, but I want the fuck out!
You are this close to being...
Hey, I already died once today! It's all a big misunderstanding! Carry on with your business!
Stop! You don't have the clearance to be here! Fucking lame! We got the exit sealed!
I should have stayed on the slab!
Don't push me! Stop!
This is fucked!
Go
this the way out?
Hey, Mike.
F. Hey, we need to talk. Quick, meet me at those oil derricks just outside town, El Burro Heights. And make sure you're not tailed.
Man, that don't sound too good, homie. Look, I'm on my way.
Dave, the hell was that? You know how many spooks I just ran into?
I'm sorry. They're not nice people, if that's a consolation.
What's going on?
There's a big target out there, something in the shadows. The data algorithms are reading off the charts. Whoever finds it, the Bureau or the agency, is gonna get a big bump in funding.
Like I care about your funding. I'm out, Dave.
You're not. I need you to meet my boss. We'll be downtown in the plaza between the FIB and the IAA buildings.
The IAA building? You fucking kidding me after the spat I just had with those agency men?
Relax. They won't be looking there. They never expect an inside job.
Hey, you hit me!
Franklin.
What's going on?
You gotta get out of town.
Man, I ain't exactly got nowhere to go.
Well, then take a trip. A long trip.
What the fuck is going on?
Things, all right? Look, you remember I told you I know people? Feds who looked after me when I retired?
You did?
Yeah, I did. I mean, I think I did. I don't know. Shit. Jesus Christ, Franklin. I got so many stories, I can't even keep them straight. I'm full of shit.
Yeah, but your full of shit got me a lot of paper. One score with you, I made more money than I ever did hustling.
Oh, yeah, I mean, I'm a great thief, but you know, it's the other shit that I ain't got figured out.
So what's the deal, man? What's the deal with the Bureau, man?
This clown. I mean, he's an okay guy. Fucking cocksucker. We did a deal a long time ago. Didn't go quite the way it was supposed to go. Wrong guy got killed. So I had to go into kind of an informal witness protection program. He helped me. I didn't reveal secrets of his. And everything was cool. The problem started when recently I became unretired. I mean, he shows up, starts calling in favors, telling me to do shit. I mean, look, Franklin, I'm working for the fucking feds.
Oh, fuck, man.
Oh, fuck, man. Yeah, and that ain't even the worst part. Did I ever tell you about Trevor?
Man, I think so. Shit.
Well, if you only think so, then I wasn't being completely honest. He's, hell walking on Earth. That's what he is.
Well, let's bury this motherfucker.
Oh, yeah, good luck with that.
Shit.
I mean, Trevor and I got history. Complicated fucking history. Look, I've done a lot of things that I ain't proud of. Okay, I never claimed to be an angel. But you meet Trevor, Franklin, you'll swear I am an angel.
So what's the mood in, man?
I don't know. Fuck. I'm just gonna, you know, try to play both sides, you know, until I can find a way out of this shit.
All right, man, look, man, you help me. The way I see it, man, the least I can do is help you.
It's a death sentence, Franklin.
Man, I ain't trying to hear all that shit, man. If the Bureau ain't gonna take you to court, them motherfuckers just hustlers anyway. And I ain't finna let no motherfucking cat think he's so motherfucking crazy run me up a tree. Fuck that.
Hey, you're a good kid, Franklin. This means a lot to me. Like I told you, I'm a terrific thief. I'll find something for you. Big. Now, come on. You better take off.
All right, man. I'm with you. I'm with you.